Hi guys, this is Dr. Beth with Area 51 Farms. I'd like to welcome you to my channel. I'm going to talk to you about, first of all, what I carry in the back of my car, and number two, what I carry in my bug out bag. Yes, my bug out bag. I think everybody needs to have a bag that they can throw stuff in and go away for a day or two and be able to survive in more than one way, so stay tuned. The back of my car looks like I'm going to go stay somewhere for like, 3 weeks, but mainly I carry medical gear because I'm always coming up on accidents and people expect me to help. And so I carry a lot of medical gear in my car, mainly things to stop bleeding because that's the most important in a car wreck. And then some other things like, otoscope and stethoscope for people who are maybe in their home that's sick or my friends that need a doctor. That's what I keep in the bag, mostly. Some things I don't want to talk about, that's private. The next thing is my bug out bag. Bug out bag. No, that's what you want to carry in your bag. No, Dexter, don't get up in the back of the car. He's getting in the back of the car to inspect. Probably because I keep food back there too a little bit. He's checking to make sure that everything's in its place. I have a bug out bag mainly in case I have to spend the night somewhere unexpectedly or the weather gets bad and I have to be at the hospital. You can put all sorts of things in the bug out bag, and I do carry things in the event that I'm stranded and I have to stay on the road or in the woods. So I'll go through my bag. Yeah. So this is the bag. It's a military style bag that I got. I obviously carry some soap on it. I got my name because I thought that was cool, Medic Milligan. And then this is just a cool thing, World Gone Silent. That's because I do operate a ham radio sometimes in emergencies. And that's a little cool dually bob somebody gave me that gives you the temperature, and it's got a compass. So you get all kinds of cool things at medical conferences. And then I've got these carabines or whatever you call them in there to hang stuff off of. At the top, I have a flashlight here that I can attach to the top of my hat if I'm out on the road. And then I've got some binoculars, and then I've got a knife. Everybody needs a knife, a pocket knife, and that thing gives me around when I need to. And I also have a smaller version of a multi-tool here that's really efficient and got a little screwdriver and things on there. That's in the top pocket. Because I'm a physician, I'm always thinking medical, so I actually have a tiny medical kit. And I love these little bags. I get them for free at medical conferences and other, actually this came from a health insurance company, but anyway, they gave me this little bag here, and I put various and sundry things in there, UC medications that I have to take, and here's what I carry, and I want you to think about it. So if you're a patient and you have a special medication you couldn't live without, and yes, there are meds like that, blood thinners and blood pressure pills, I carry, and I can't advertise the medicine, but I carry my blood thinner with me, and I carry enough for a week at all times for emergencies. You never know, guys, you never know. I worked the Katrina hurricane, and the one thing was people were fleeing without their medicines, and you can't live without them. I carry a lighter. Yeah, I can start fires the traditional way, but why not learn how to do it the easy way. I carry a little bit of fire starter, fire fuel fuses, if I need to do that. And I think that's mainly what I've got in there. A little bit of alcohol pads. I stick things in the most unsundry places. And then here's an emergency fire starter if you don't have a fire, a lighter. That's what's in that particular pocket. The next pocket, I've just got some of these little magnified glass plastic sheets. Actually, they're not glass. If you could start a fire that way, you could. Here's a little thing to carry. It's collapsible, a little water container thingy. I've also got the charger for my ham radio. You don't have to see that. That's not anything fun to look at. I have a lighter that I could pop and break and sit out on the road if I'm trying to work with someone at night time. And yes, I've done that. A little magnifying glass, some other odds and ends that probably aren't worth looking at. Oh yeah, these are these pocket tool kits I buy them. You can break them down. It's a little cutting tool, various things in there. I like odds and ends that I can buy for really cheap or pick up at the flea markets, etc. And then here's one thing, if I can pull it out here. This is a little thing you can carry on your keychain. Just don't carry it in the airport. And it's a little pocket knife. It's kind of sharp. Collapses down, and you can put it on your keychain. Another little toy that I think is fun. So let's look in the next pocket. Another medical kit. I got this flea. You can get Altoid cans and make these. And I'll do a whole video on what I put in my little pocket medical kits. I love making them, and I customize them to the medical problems you have. So we'll do that. That's another topic. But I've got several in here because I have issues with needing to keep my blood thin, my blood pressure controlled. All right, next pocket. This is the biggest pocket I have, and I always carry something to stop bleeding because I'm on blood thinners. I think everybody should carry these. If you're in a car, you see somebody in a car wreck that's bleeding just really bad, you can grab these things. This is what I got out of the just one brand. I don't work for these people. I'd like to. Guys, if you work for Quick Clot, give me a hit up, holler. I'll sell this product for you. But yeah, if you get cut and you're on blood thinners or really bad, you can do it. I carry a little thing to take notes with, just a traditional pen and paper, toothbrush, yes. I don't know why you carry it to brush your teeth. I've got a Life Straw to be able to purify water with. Got some rope there, tiny rope. You can also, it's jute string. You can actually, I got it at the arts and crafts store for like a buck. It's 10 yards. You can do all sorts of stuff with that. Got a way to cut things with, and I can show that later, but it's a cutting tool, a little tiny candle that will probably burn for an hour, razor in case I need to shave my chin. You know, you get lost in the wood and you start growing facial hair. You don't want anybody to catch you later when a news team comes to pick you up. Another tiny medical kit that I bought. I don't even know what's in there. I bought that all-purpose first aid kit. Who knows? I wanted to see if I could make one better than them. This is just some fire starting stuff I got from the woods and put in there. Guys, here's the most important, toilet paper. You know you can do that yourself, but always carry a roll. You never know when I'm out of the country. I use that sometimes. A hairbrush, a portable hairbrush that someone gave me, not that I carry about that in the woods. Something, a mirror. I can tell you tons of ways to use your mirror. And some more wire here that you can use to set up to make shelter. An antenna for my ham radio. A ham radio is another thing that you can watch on here, a thing to watch, Germex to watch my hands, like that's a big deal. And my business cards. Why is that in here? I don't really know. That's kind of silly. I have another compartment, okay? The tiny little compartment here is a thermal blanket. You can wrap it around people who are cold or are bleeding and try to keep them warm. I've got an entire fire starting kit here with just stuff I bought that's all separate, and I can do something later on that. There's a lot of YouTube videos on people that talk about how to start fires, and then a little tiny fishing kit. Yes, a tiny fishing kit. I'll show you how to make one of them. My husband's a Boy Scout, and I've had a couple of veterans that are Boy Scouts that have taught me how to do that. I can even make a pocket size fishing kit. And then here's another, I think I got this free. I won't advertise the person that gave it to me, but I pick this stuff up everywhere, but it's a little sewing kit. So I need to sew something in the woods in the middle of emergency. You can do that. It's sewing actually clothes. You can actually sew skin with stuff in an extreme emergency. There's a lot of things you can put in your kit. That's what I'm using in my kit. I've got several, but that's what I'm in there today. I'll probably change it tomorrow, the next day, because I change my mind all the time. It's fun making them, and I'll go through more detail on how I make these sometimes. Well, what I make for my emergency medical kits, and what to think about to carry one. Thank you for visiting my channel. If you stayed this long, I hope you have a blessed day. Bye.